Hello guys, in this video we will learn about one-dimensional and two-dimensional arrays in C. So first let us understand what are arrays and why do we even need these arrays. So arrays are nothing but these are a collection of values having similar data type. Until now we have just been representing numbers using say integer a or int a, int b, int c and so on, and we did not actually use arrays till now. The question is, why do we even need to use the arrays when we have the option to declare variables and then use them? So the idea behind using arrays is that suppose if you have some large piece of code and you need several variables and all those variables say perform a similar task, then what are you supposed to do? Suppose if you want to store the marks of n students in a subject, say physics, then you cannot declare variables like m1, m2, m3 and till M50. That is not a correct way to do it. So instead what we'll use is, we will use a simple array and then store values or store marks into that array. So arrays are a collection of values having similar data type. First of all, it avoids the declaration of several variables, and second, it also makes it easy for you to remember your variable names. Otherwise, if you have a very large program, more than half of your time will just vanish trying to search what your variable name is. So that is a good flexibility that arrays provide us. Arrays are stored in contiguous locations in memory. That means they are stored one beside other. For example, if we have a memory location say 1000, then the first array variable or first data will be stored in 1000, then in 1002 if it is an int obviously, then in 1004, then 1006 and so on. That means they're given continuous memory locations or continuous memory blocks in your storage. Arrays are of two types. The first type is one dimensional array and the second one is two dimensional array. So first of all we'll take a look at one dimensional array. One dimensional means nothing but a linear array. We need to understand two things. There is the first thing called element, which is the actual value that you'll be storing in this array, and second is the address, that is the location in memory of that particular value. And one more thing is there, that is the indexing of values in an array. So first of all, let us assume that this is one array that we have and the size of this array is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And indexing is done starting from 0. For any array, the indexing always starts from 0. Say suppose it is an integer array. The address of the first value will be 1000, then second value will be 1002, then 1004, 1006, 1008 and so on. Over here we have this one, that is our variable is roll, maybe a roll number of some student. These are the values. The first value is 12, then 45, 32, 23, 17, 49, 5 and 11. And these are the addresses where those values are stored. So the first value is stored at 1000, then 1002, 1004 and so on till 1014. So that is how arrays are stored in memory obviously. Now the indexing is done as because we have the same name for all the elements. That means using that same name we are referring all the elements, then obviously there needs to be some way using which we can understand, okay, this first value is 12, second value is 45. So that is the concept of index. The value that is written inside these pair of square brackets is known as the index. And roll 0 corresponds to 12, roll 1 corresponds to 45, roll 2 32, roll 3 23 and so on till roll 7, which corresponds to 17. Now let us take a look at two-dimensional array. Two-dimensional array is nothing but a matrix. This matrix can be square or rectangular. We can actually have arrays of any dimension, but then say three dimensional or 4, 5, 6 or whatever you want. But then managing that multi-dimensional array becomes difficult. That is why we use only two-dimensional arrays or at the most three-dimensional arrays if the need arises. In a two-dimensional arrays, the values are stored in the form of tables, and every table contains rows, that is the horizontal blocks, and columns, that is the vertical block. So in order to access this first element, the cornermost element, we have the row number as 0 and column number as 0. It is quite obvious. So that means the element is A00. The next one is A01. 0 is the row number, 1 is the column number. Then we have A02, A03. In the second row, we have A10. In the third row, we have A20. Again, the indexing starts from 0 and for row as well as for column. That is why we are writing 00 here, 10 here, 20 here, and so on. And the last value is A23. Now, these two-dimensional arrays are nothing, but they are arrays of an array. What that means is, say this is one array containing three variables, that is three values, that is 8, 10, 12. The next array is 5, 4, 6. Next one is 7, 8, 9. And these arrays are then stored in another array, where at the first position we have this array, in the second position we have this, third position we have this. Now let us take a look at address calculation of 1D arrays. Suppose we have this array with elements 15, 7, 11, 14, 44, 93, and 20. And these are the addresses of these elements in memory. And these are obviously the index of the elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The starting address of the array, or the address of the first element in the array, is known as the base address. Over here, the base address is 1100, because this is our starting element, which is indexed as 0. So this starting element, or the first element, is known as the lower limit or lower bound. Obviously, the actual address of the first element of the array is known as base address, which I just told you. And this is the width. Memory space acquired by every element in the array is called width. Over here, the width is 100. The width is 4, because see, the address of 44 was 1112, and the address of 93 was 1116. So the width is 1116 minus 1112. So that turns out to be 4. And it is quite obvious, because in 64-bit machines, integer values have size 4, which we saw earlier. So that's why this integer acquires 4 bytes of space, this one acquires 4, this one 4, this one 4, and so on. Now, over here, when we want to calculate the address of 1D arrays, we have few notations that you have to remember. First is B. This B means base address. W means storage size of one element stored in the array, and the size is in bytes. This is the W. And next is I. I is the subscript of element whose address is to be found. Suppose if you want to calculate the value of A5, then your value of I will be 5. And LB is equal to lower bound of subscript. If not specified, then assume it to be 0. So LB is this lower bound. Your indexing generally starts from 0. So if the lower bound is not specified in the question, then just assume it that the lower bound is 0. Now, the formula is, address of AI is calculated as base address plus width multiplied by I minus LB. Suppose over here, we want to calculate the address of A4. The base address is 1100 over here. So B is equal to 1100 plus width. The width is 4 bytes, which is quite obvious, we can see that. So width is 4 bytes. I, this I is the index. So I is 4 minus LB. Over here, assume that LB is 0. So what will be the address? 4 minus 0 multiplied by this W. So 4 minus 0 is 4, width is again 4, so 4 multiplied by 4 is 16, and base address is 1100. So 1100 plus 16 gives us 1116. So obviously we can see the value, the address of 93, or the fourth element, is 116. When you want to represent 2D arrays, there are actually two methods to represent 2D arrays. The first one is row major, and second one is column major. This row major notation is used in programming languages like C, C++, etc. And column major representation is used in languages like Fortran. So in row major order, what we have is, okay, first of all, let us assume that this is one two-dimensional array that we have, and the size of this array is 2 cross 3, because we have 2 rows and 3 columns. Now obviously, as I already told you, that two-dimensional arrays are nothing but arrays of arrays. So we can always represent the 2D array in the form of a singular array or a linear array. Over here, we have 6 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose the address to the first element, that is A11, is 0. Second element is stored at address 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. So we have 0 to 5 addresses starting from 0 to 5. Obviously 6 elements. So in row major order, what will happen is the elements will be stored row wise. We span this 2D array, or we span this matrix row wise. So starting from A11, then A12, then A13, then we go to A21, A22, A23. There you see. In address 0, we have A11, then we have A12, then we have A13. So first row is complete. Now in the third address, we have A21, in fourth A22, and fifth is A23. So our second row is also complete. Now in column major, what we do is the address of the first one is A11, then we write A21. That means we span through the columns. So this is our first column, this is our second column, this is our third column. So in the first column, the first value is A11, that's why we have A11. The second value is A21, so we have A21. So our first column is complete. Now in the second column, we have first value as A12, so we write A12. Then we have A22, so second column is done. In third column, we have A13 and then A23. So that's why three columns and hence six values. So this was the row major order, this was the column major order. And you can always expect question from address calculation in your exams. So make sure that you practice it and you remember the formula very nicely. Now, we just saw how to calculate addresses of 1D arrays, or addresses of elements of 1D arrays. Now we will see how to calculate address of elements of 2D arrays. Over here, there are two formulas. The first one is for row major, second is for column major. Now, suppose your 2D array was the first, starting from the first row, A00 equal to 8, A01 is 6, A02 is 5, then 4, then in the second row you have 2, then 1, then 9, then 7, then third row you have 3642. So that obviously can be represented in the form of a linear array. So the first four values correspond to row 0, then row 1, then row 2. So this is row major form, and over here this is column major form, because we had four columns, that's why we have four distinct blocks. Now in address calculation of 2D arrays, we have few notations. The first one is I. I is the row subscript of element whose address is to be found, and J is the column subscript of element whose address is to be found. Suppose if you want to find the address of A23, then I will be 2 and J will be 3. Next is W. W is the same as before. W is the storage byte of, so storage size of one element stored in the array. If it is an integer, then W will be 4 in case of 64-bit machines. Then we have LR. LR is the lower limit of row or start row index of a matrix. If not given, then assume it to be 0. Just like in the previous case where we assumed the index to be 0 if it was not given, over here we assume the lower limit to be 0 if it is not given. And LC is the lower limit of column. And also, this one you can assume to be 0 if it is not mentioned. M is the number of rows and N is the number of columns in the given matrix or the 2D array. And if the number of rows and columns are not directly given to you, then what you can do is, you can write UR minus LR plus 1. This UR is the upper limit of row and LR is the lower limit of row. So UR minus LR will give you some value, add a 1 to it, then you will get the number of rows. And similarly, if you want to calculate the number of columns, you can write UC minus LC plus 1. Okay, now let's take a look at the formula. The formula in the row major system is Aij is equal to B, which is the base address, plus W, which is the width of or size of one element, multiplied by, actually this W is multiplied with this entire thing. One bracket is, okay, the other bracket is shifted over here. So the formula is N, which is the number of columns, multiplied by I minus LR. This I is the row index and LR is the lower limit. So I minus LR. This N is multiplied with this I minus LR. Then we have plus J minus LC. This J is the column subscript whose address is to be found and LC is the lower limit of columns. So the formula is n multiplied by I minus LR plus j minus LC, and this entire thing will be multiplied with a W, then added to the base address. And in the column measure system, the only change is that we multiply one M with the second part. We do not multiply anything with the first part. We just multiply this M, or the number of rows, with the second part. So the formulas, you can compare and see, both the formulas are same. You can remember just one formula, and the other and in the other formula, what you have to do is, if you remember the row measure formula, then for column measure formula, you just remove this N and the asterisk sign from here and place one M and the asterisk sign over here. So you will get the column measure system. So that was address calculation of 2D arrays. Now let's take a look at one example. The question is, given the base address of an array B starting from 1300 ending to 1900 as 1020. That means the base array of the base address of this array is 1020, and size of each element is 2 bytes. So find the address of B1700. So first of all, what you do is you write down all the values. So we have B is equal to 1020, the base address. LB is equal to 1300, which was given, the lower bound of the array. W is equal to 2, which was again given, the size is 2 bytes. And I is equal to 1700, which you have to find. Then you write the formula. AI is equal to B plus W into I minus LB. And then you just substitute the values that you have and calculate it. You'll get the value as 1820. So this 1820 is the address of B1700. Now look at an example for a 2D array. Over here, the question is, an array X minus 15 to minus 10, comma 15 to 40 requires 1 byte of storage. If beginning location is 1500, determine the location of X 15, 20. As you can see here, the number of rows and columns are not given. So you first need to determine that using the formula that I'd given. So M is equal to UR minus LR plus 1. UR is equal to 10, this value, and LR is equal to minus 15. So you write 10 minus minus 15 plus 1. So the value is 26. Similarly, you have to calculate N. N is equal to 40 minus 15 plus 1. That is again 26. Now just write the given values, which is B is equal to 1500, W equal to 1 byte, requires 1 byte of storage, that's given. I is equal to 15, J 20, LR minus 15, LC 15, M 26, N 26. Now just place the values in the formula. In column measure form, address of AIJ is equal to B plus W into I minus LR plus M into J minus LC. Putting the values in the question, in the formula, you'll get the answer as 1660. And for row measure, if you write the formula and put the values, you'll get the answer as 2285. You'll get many examples in whichever book you are following. You just solve the examples and the formulas are very easy to remember. That is all for this video. We will discuss some programs on arrays when we study the pointers chapter. Thank you.